Hey, welcome to episode 24 of Tech Tips, a student computing podcast. I'm your host, Andy. Today we're talking about Windows 7, a brand new release from Microsoft. It just came out back in October, but there's still a lot of questions and concerns and excitement about it. So we thought we'd address that and show you a couple features, show around a little bit. There's a lot of buzz and a lot of interest, but there's generally a really good impression of Windows 7. So we're going to talk about it. Today we're going to go over if your computer is right for Windows 7. That's the most important thing you need to know right now, is if it's going to work for your computer and if it's going to be a good experience for you. And then we'll talk about some of the under-the-hood improvements, and in the next episode we'll be going into some visual cool new features and then, you know, get in and actually show you around. Alright, so here we are checking out Windows 7. Let's talk about what you need first. These are the minimum specifications. You need a 1 GHz or faster processor. Honestly, this is probably not going to be a problem. The 1 GHz was introduced about 9.5 years ago, so this is not going to be something that will prohibit you from getting Windows 7. Now, obviously, you'll get a better experience if you have a faster processor, but this isn't going to, you know, cut you off from getting it at all. 1 GB of memory. Most computers have had that for the past couple years. If you bought a really low-end model, then you might not. The good thing is that memory is pretty cheap and easy to upgrade, and it's one of the cheapest components of the computer, so if you need an upgrade, then that's definitely not off the table. 16 gigs of hard drive space, that's really not usually a problem for anybody nowadays either. Here's a tough one. DirectX 9 graphics device with WDDM 1.0 or higher driver. That's according to Microsoft. Let me boil that down for you in easy talk rather than tech talk. So basically, any computer that runs Windows Vista and is fully compatible and came with Windows Vista, was shipped with it and all that, should be fully compatible with that DirectX 9. And that shouldn't be a problem at all. Now, the problem is when if your computer came with XP, that's when it gets tricky, because Microsoft kind of ramped up the market there with Vista and said, hey, we need you guys to juice up your video cards a little bit so you'll have a little more power so we can run some of these nice effects that'll make it look good. So a lot of manufacturers really ramped up their production at that point. If you have a computer that shipped with XP, then you may or may not be compatible with this. If you have a higher-end model that has a nice graphics device, or if you bought the thing specifically for gaming or anything like that, then you're probably in good shape. But if you have a cheaper onboard, like an Intel, it may or may not be compatible. I will say that it does say it's compatible or not. However, you can run Windows 7 without having this, but let me tell you, it's a really miserable experience. You get most of your features hacked off. There's all kinds of stuff that would normally look really nice and work well that just doesn't function. In that case, I would really highly recommend you just keep with Windows XP. XP has a smaller footprint, so it's going to use your system better anyway. That's what it was shipped for, as well as designed for, and you're probably a lot better off sticking with that. So, let's move on. Improvements. Optimizations and streamlining. That was a big thing with all the software developers lately, is trying to make things run more efficiently. And the nice thing is that they've actually improved the optimized and improved upon a lot of the stuff they wrote with Windows Vista. So, if you currently have Windows Vista, Windows 7 may give you better performance. I know that sounds crazy because it's new and it should be more resource intensive and harder. But actually, they've streamlined it so that it is actually kind of a step back on that. So it's going to use your memory better. And the nice thing is, if you do already have a Vista machine with that WDDM 1.0, then it's going to actually use that a little more efficiently too. So those fancy effects are going to run a little better, and they've actually added some more that run pretty well. The other thing is UAC, that's User Access Control. That's basically the thing that pops up that says, are you sure you want to do this? It blacks out the screen and it says, you know, are you allowing this application to continue what it's doing? With Windows Vista, they got a lot of pushback because it kept popping up all the time every time you were trying to do something. They've put in a couple more options there. So they got a couple more levels, so now with Vista, it's either on or off. Just cut and dry, on or off. With Windows 7, it's got a couple levels you can set. So you can set it to the maximum so it'll always pop up, or you can tone it down a little bit so that it'll, you know, just kind of continue on and know that that's what you're doing. UAC is a security feature, so I wouldn't recommend disabling it, but Windows 7 does have an option to throttle it down just a little bit to make it a little more user-friendly. Improve battery life. Windows 7 will actually improve your battery life a little bit. Now, it's probably not going to work miracles, but it runs a little more efficiently, so it's not using as much power. Kind of gets better gas mileage, if you will. There's also touchscreen and multi-touch capability. Most hardware isn't compatible with that yet, but that's something we can definitely look forward to in the future. Alright, that's it for Tech Tips today, but next time we'll be getting in and showing you around Windows 7 a little bit more. By the way, if you have any topics you'd like to hear us talk about or just want to give us some feedback, we'd love to hear from you guys. So go ahead and shoot us an email at the address right here, and we'll catch you next time on Tech Tips.